Meanwhile, we're down to the final skater for the ladies. Yoshie Onda has the lead right now over Yelena Lyashenko and Angela Nikodinov, and it comes down to Tatiana Malinina from Uzbekistan, who was in third place after the short program. She controls her own destiny here. About to find out who not only wins the gold medal, but also the two skaters who will occupy the remaining spots of the Grand Prix final. And Angela Nikodinov, who looks so good, her chances look so good going into the free skate. Now she's biting her nails.
Oh man, was that a hard fall. When you don't get your hands down to stop your fall like that, that's more than a shock. It all out hurts. Boy, did she get it back though on that triple flip. That is focus. That's exactly what you need to do.
If the standings remain the same, the two spots would be filled by Yoshie Onda and Angela Nikodinov. Malinina could steal one here, though.
Look at that. I'm just so impressed with the ability she has to refocus after that terrible fall.
Peter, she certainly got the experience. Great year that she had in 99 when she won the Grand Prix final. Won the Four Continents Championship that year. Came in fourth in the world. A couple of tough seasons followed, though.
Trying to keep it together here on this triple toe loop. Oh, bending at the waist like that just throws you to the ice.
Tatiana ranked ninth in the latest ISU World Rankings. Originally from Russia. Has lived in Dale City, Virginia for a number of years. Also spent some time training in Prague.
But Terry, you know what's on her mind right now? She has planned another triple Lutz in this program. Remember that hard fall that she had in the beginning of the program. If she can focus and land this triple Lutz, that will be huge for her. She did it! Wow, that is impressive. I mean, because you're so undone by something like that in the beginning of the program, and she got it back. Look at that smile on her face. She knows she's jumped over a huge hurdle. Double axel.
About keeping your composure, Peter.
I am so impressed with that, and she should be psyched. I mean, that was really showing amazing intestinal fortitude to rally like that and hit that triple Lutz. That was really terrific.
She's had such a tough time in the past year and a half or so after that great season in 99. It's great to see Tatiana Malinina back skating well. Did she just win the gold medal and a spot at the Grand Prix final? We'll have to wait and see. She may have knocked Angela Nikodinov out. We'll have to wait for that.
This was the opening triple Lutz. This is the one she had problems on. Look at, she gets up into the air, but she's starting to lean, and I cannot believe the fall she has here. Bang! I mean, it's amazing to think that she was able to recover after that. That was truly amazing.
She can't even get to the kiss and cry area. Look at all the stuffed animals and flowers. Here's the first set now. 5.2 up to 5.5, Peter.
Well, I tell you, had she not had mistakes, they would have been higher, but I don't care about that right now. She skated well, and she made a huge comeback.
Presentation marks. Here they are. 5-1 up to 5-6. And the ordinals from the judges, Tatiana Malinina is going to win the NHK trophy. She captures the gold medal and gets a trip to the Grand Prix final. Yoshia Honda from Japan ends up with the silver medal, and she is going to the final as well. A heartbreaker for Angela Nikodinov. She gets bounced. Look at the reaction.
That was a big comeback. She should be overwhelmed with emotion. Tremendous.
So the 28-year-old from Uzbekistan captures her first Grand Prix win since 99. Yoshie Honda of Japan up for the silver medal and gets a trip to the Grand Prix final. Yelena Lyashenko captures the bronze ahead of Angela Nikodinov and Patrice McDonough of the U.S., a strong sixth-place finish and an extremely disappointing seventh-place finish for Fumie Suguri of Japan. Take a look at our Smart One Smart Move replay. The triple flip from Tatiana Malinina. A great sign. It came right after the fall on the opening triple Lutz. A good sign that she was going to keep her poise and fight through the free skate. Peter has made his way over to have a word with the winner.
How did you come back after that fall?
I have just little mistakes because, I don't know, maybe just in first time in my program, I feel not comfortable, but I have lots of control when I skate, and this has just happened.
Well, control that's going to take you right to the Grand Prix final. Congratulations.
Really?
You bet.
No! Unbelievable, no!
You're going.
You sure?
Yes.
Oh my God! I don't have second program.
Get it ready. Terry, back to you.
That is about as honest a reaction as you're going to get. Now she has to put another program together. Good problem to have, though. On the opposite end of the emotional spectrum, Angela Nikodinov. She had the lead. She let it slip away in the free skate. Peter is with her now.
Angela, that was a heartbreaker. Now, you said in the warm-up you felt pretty good. What happened between the warm-up and the actual competition?
I felt really relaxed. I just feel really exhausted and I had no energy to really get nervous. But, you know, it's not an excuse. It's been a very long month for me and I had two pretty successful competitions and the short program was better than the last two. And so I'm not going to let this get me down and just go back home and train harder and get myself together for our nationals and hopefully qualify for the Olympics. And it's just been a very long month for me.
Well, good luck with the rest of the season, and we know you're going to fight on.
Thank you.
All right, Peter, thank you. So Angela Nikodinov will be the first alternate for the Grand Prix final. Tatiana Malinina and Yoshie Honda pass her in the standings to claim the last two spots in that final. They will be there in Kitchener, Ontario, Canada, along with Maria Butyrskaya.